Let us see one more example. Y is equal to sin x. Let me take one trigonometric function. So this is f of x. F of x plus delta x is equal to sin, wherever x is present, you substitute x plus delta x. So x plus delta x. Now dy by dx is equal to limit delta x tends to 0, f of x plus delta x, so that is sin x plus delta x minus f of x minus sin x by delta x. You write down. So it is like sin c minus sin d. In trigonometry we have studied it. Sin c minus sin d equal to 2 cos. So limit delta x tends to 0, sin c minus sin d equal to 2 cos c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2, right? 2 cos c plus d by 2, this total term is c, this x is d, so c plus d by 2, x plus delta x plus x by 2 sin c minus d by 2, x plus delta x minus x by 2 whole by delta x as usual. So this can be written as limit delta x tends to 0 2 cos x plus x 2x, 2x plus delta x by 2, so x plus delta x by 2 I can write. Sin minus x plus x cancel, delta x by 2, delta x by 2, that's it. So whole by delta x, so I can write this 2 here by 2. Now dy by dx is equal to limit delta x tends to 0 cos of x plus delta x by 2 into, again I am writing limit for this, limit sin delta x by 2 by delta x by 2, where delta x tends to 0 or delta x by 2 tends to 0. Here one important formula that you have to know, that limit theta tends to 0 sin theta by theta is equal to 1. How? Okay, let me clarify this. Sin 30 degrees. Sin 30 degrees how much? 1 by 2. I can take sin 30 as 30 degrees as pi by 6 radian. So this pi by 6 value let me calculate, 3.14 by 6. What you are going to get? 0.5 approximately, 0.52. So this will be again 0.5. The exact value is 0.5. instead of calculating sin 30 degrees, if I take that angle in radians separately and calculate it, you'll be getting the same value, and it is more correct when theta is very less. That means instead of calculating sin 5 degrees, just convert 5 degrees into radians and calculate that value, it almost the same. Instead of calculating sin 10 degrees, instead of calculating sin 10 degrees, better to calculate 10 degrees. 10 degrees means 10 into pi by 180, that means pi by 18. So whatever be the value of pi by 18, you'll be getting sin 10 degrees same. So instead of calculating sin theta, you can calculate theta value separately, but that theta must be in radians. So it is more correct for theta very much very lesser values. That means I can take sin theta as theta, theta by theta is 1. In the same way, here theta tends to 0. Here sin of delta x by 2, here again delta x by 2, here again delta x by 2. tends to 0. So sine of delta x by 2 can be taken as delta x by 2. Delta x by 2, delta x by 2 is 1. So this total term will be 1. And wherever delta x is there, you substitute 0. So cos x plus 0 into 1. So it is cos x. That means dy by dx, dy by dx, or y is equal to sin x. That's why d by dx of sin x is equal to cos x. This is one more. How many we have to do? Because many trigonometric ratios we are having, that many I can't do like this. I can't go for proof because it is not important for us in physics. That's why I will tell you some formulas. You try to remember all those, and whenever it is needed, we will directly use those formulas.